Greg from the Ontario Science Center, and today I'll show you some cool tricks you can try at home using static electricity. Here's another challenge you can try at home. See if you can move a pop can off of a table without touching it. Go ahead, pause here and give it a try. All matter, from basketballs to books, is made up of charges. Positive protons and negative electrons. When you rub two different materials together, like, say, cotton and rubber, electrons from one will get transferred to the other, building up a static charge. And we call this charging by friction. Once you've generated a static charge, you can use it to do a whole bunch of things, like move a can without even touching it. These challenges are a lot more challenging if you try them yourself. When I tried that last challenge at my house, I ended up using a rubber balloon and a cotton towel. But honestly, I have no idea what materials you have at your place. So try a bunch of different things. Do metal and styrofoam. Do fleece and glass. You could even do plastic and cat fur. Some combinations work great. Others, not so much. Find whatever combination works best for you. Don't worry, I'll wait. Oh, welcome back. Now that you've perfected your charging technique, you can challenge your family and friends. When I'm at the Ontario Science Center, we have a huge static electricity generator to make people's hair stand up. Here at home, this is the best I can do. This balloon is made of rubber, which means it's good for rubbing. It's also good at taking and holding on to electrons. When I rub the balloon on my head, electrons are transferred from my hair to the balloon. These extra negative charges give the balloon an overall negative charge. And because my hair lost some of its negative electrons, it's left with a positive charge. As you can see, the negative charge on the balloon and the positive charge on my hair are attracted to each other. Or you could say opposite charges attract. Here's another challenge you can try with your family. See if you can balance a plate on top of a cup. Seems easy, right? There, no problem. But what if I charge them first? The plate and the cup, they're made out of the same material, polystyrene or styrofoam, which means when I rub them on the same thing, in this case my hair, they should pick up the same charge. And as we can see, things with the same charge repel each other. We've seen that opposite charges attract, and like charges repel. But what happens when you have a charged object and a neutral one? Welcome to my bathroom. This water is statically neutral because, try as I might, I just can't seem to charge it by friction. What do you think will happen when I bring a negatively charged hairbrush near the neutral water? I'll wash my hands while I let you think about it. Happy birthday to you, happy birthday to you, happy birthday dear Science Center. As you can see, the neutral water is attracted to the negatively charged hairbrush. Is that what you guessed? We actually saw this same effect before when I moved the pop can with the balloon. The water contains roughly the same number of positive charges as negative charges, making it neutral overall. When I bring the negatively charged hairbrush near the water, the electrons are repelled, leaving a positive region near the brush. The positive charges in the water are then attracted to the negative hairbrush, causing the stream to bend. The negatively charged hairbrush repelled the water's electrons and bent the stream towards it. But what would happen with a positively charged object? Glass has a pretty weak hold on its electrons, so when you rub it on something like silk or polyester, it will give up its electrons, leaving it with a positive charge. You may have noticed by now that it always seems to be the electrons that move around, and never the positive protons. That's because electrons are about 1,000 times smaller than protons, and they're in shells on the outside of the atom, making it easier for them to move around and transfer between materials. That's probably why it's called electricity, and not protonicity. If the negative hairbrush bent the water, what will the positive glass bottle do? I'm not going to show you the answer to this one. You'll have to try it in your own bathroom. Now that I've shown you how to charge an object, I guess I should show you how to discharge them too. After all, I don't want you stuck like this forever. Objects are naturally neutral, with the same number of positive and negative charges. When an object has more of one than the other, we say that it's charged. The hairbrush has more negative charges than positive ones, while the bottle has more positive than negative. To discharge them, we need something really big, with so many charges that it's able to accept a few extra, while also giving up some of its own. For that, we use the ground, because it's pretty much the biggest thing on Earth. And we call it grounding, because scientists aren't always very creative with their names. When I rub a balloon on my head, my hair develops a positive charge. To get back to neutral, I need some negative charges from the ground. I can do this by touching something connected to the ground, like this metal tap. And my hair should fall back down to normal. Of course, you can also discharge yourself by touching someone who's touching the ground.
Ow.
Just don't be surprised when they get annoyed with you. Today we used friction to charge objects, saw that opposite charges attract while like charges repel, and grounded ourselves back to neutral. Watching this video is a start. The next step is to try some of these static tricks for yourself.